Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. If you've ever been in the situation where you said, oh no, bad idea, and started pressing Control Z and hoping for your editor to have enough undo to get out of the problem that you're in, well, then you need improvement in your Git workflow. I'll show you my workflow in this episode. Okay, let's look at the code from last week. I need some code to change in here. So I had this code that in part three needed a bit of improvement, and it went like this. Let's make this const, and then we came to the realization last week, well, that doesn't work unless this is const, and that doesn't work unless these are mutable. And we compiled, and yes, everything was cool. And this stage, I might not be ready to commit my code because there are still other changes. So what I'll do is I'll go to my shell over here and I'll run a small command called git save. And git save is just an alias. I think I can do it like this. I can't git aliases. Here's all my aliases. Git save commit minus mvip minus a minus no verify. So what that just does is that it pushes a commit here that's called VIP. It's just to save without actually pushing. And that's the thing we talked about. You are making some changes. And at some point, you come to a realization that was a bad road. But you already saved the files, and maybe you did not watch last week's or a few weeks ago's episode on setting up backup of your files every 10 minutes. After that situation, then the only thing you have left is undo, which is a terrible situation to be in. And even with the backup every 10 minutes, if this change has been going on for a very long time, it is rather tedious to find exactly which of your backups to restore. Okay, we got back in my editor here again, and there was another change here, and that was the ampersand that I admit I didn't understand. Looks good. I will, of course, test my code, go over here again, git save. What else was there? There was this thing about stut. Oh, come on, give me a break, Jesper. The stut once flag. So might have been a suggestion, and I started writing the stut one flag, and I saved, and more stut one flag, and I saved. And ooh, I cannot figure out how that works. Well, good that I have these things over here, because I'll just do a git reset --- hard. And if you're using setsh, the set shell, put a space in front that will make it not go into your history. That's just a small tip. We're back here with what it looked like before I did my changes. And yes, my Qt creator will suggest to me to actually load those changes. And that's good. Yeah, that was what it looked like. At this stage, I'm now done with my change. I want to push it upstream for review. And of course, I do not want to have all the VIPs in my upstream, so I'll merge them all into one. And I'll actually do a git reset to get back to the page. Not a git reset --- hard, just a git reset, because that will make it go all back into my work directory and I can commit it while reviewing my code. But a pro tip here, do a final git save if you have changes in there. Just in case that your git reset and everything goes wrong, you can always get back with git reflog to that stage just before. Let's have a look. So over in my shell, git log, I can see I got my changes here for 3 and 4 minutes ago. And I can see that this chart down here, that is where it all started. I could have put a tag or something, but it's okay for me to just have this chart. Control C to copy it. And now I'll do a git reset to this SHA that I have there. And you can see my git log now says, hey, we're back to before any of all of this. But I can also see that I actually do have my changes in here. The thing that I'll do now is that I will do I'll do one of three things. Either I will do a git add -p. Git add -p, as you can see here, it shows me chunk by chunk. Do you want to add this? And I'm like, oh yeah, that was the thing about the ampersand, and this was a constant. Yeah, that's perfectly okay. Do you want to add this? oh, I had a Qt debug in there just for my debugging purposes, or maybe I should have changed that. How about the calculator up there? That should have been const. So maybe I'll say no and go back and edit my code and do this again. Or I'll say yes, and now I'm all the way through, and I can do my commit from here. Or the other thing I can do, let me just git reset again, is that I have two aliases. I have git da, which means diff and add, and then I specify the file here, and it gives me a warning that is rather interesting, because it's just okay to add, that's fine with you. I meant part three. There we are. So, going well, huh? Git da part three. There we are. Now we'll do a diff on the whole file, and it'll ask me at the end, is that okay? And I've been looking at the whole file. Sometimes that's easier than do it chunk by chunk. I'll say yeah, and then it will show me a git log showing me what else is there, and I'll say, okay, git da, and then, well, part three, I already did that, but had I had that, then I would have done that. That's the second way that I would do this, and the final one, let me just git reset again here, is that inside my Qt creator, what I'll do is that I'll, and let me see, these are one of those moments where it's in my fingers, not in my brain, I'll do alt glc, which will bring up this git commit. And now I can see all the files. I will click at them one at a time. I'll look through and say, good. And I'll say, let's take this one here. And now we are ready to commit. So you ask, Jesper, when do you use the git add minus p, the git da? And when do you do it from within Qt Creator? You just showed us three methods of doing this. And the honest answer is, I don't know. I think that I do the git add minus p when I have smaller chunks in lots of files where I might want to back some of them out again. So I made two changes, and I know that, yeah, this one change I want in a commit by itself, and this other change I want that in a commit by itself later on. Then I'll pick them one by one with git add minus p. And git da, that's when I have some changes, that is a lot of changes in a number of files, and I don't want to do yes. So if I make some larger refactorings or some such. Doing it from within Qt Creator, I think that is my go-to in 90% of the time, where I'll just do it from within Qt Creator. It also offers this very nice facility of writing my commit log right in there. There's one more thing. One more alias that I would like to show you. Let me show you. The alias is called git whip. Well, it needs one argument, namely whatever I'm doing on. Fixing up before release. And what I did now is, as you can see over here in my prompt, I am actually now in a branch. So git log, you can see that I'm on the branch called VIP, fixing up before release. And now I can make all my changes, and you can see I actually had some changes already. So if I do a git status here, you can see that part three is still not in there. So git check in minus, we can just do git save. So now it's on that branch. I'll make some other changes. I'll eventually do let's just make some changes here. Cat into part three, better. And I'll save that too, and I'll do the git rebase minus I and so on. And eventually I'll be done with this, I'll push my changes, and then I'll want to nuke this branch. And I have a few aliases for this, git nuke, and git nuke this is basically the one that takes my changes, take this branch, throws it away unconditionally, so careful about that, and then it allows me, or it takes me back to my master branch, as you can see down here. And should you by accident have thrown it away, do remember you have git ref log that can get you back to what it was before. Yes, it was just before this one, so this would be the SHA. So git reset minus minus hard with this SHA here, and now I have my changes back. So, whew. But this will take us way too far if I need to go into much details on git reflog and so on. In this virtual world, it's sometimes useful to just walk over to one of your coworkers and say, can you show me how you do things? But of course, being virtual, that makes it slightly more difficult. So I hope that you enjoyed me sharing my workflow with regular Git today. I hope that you will give something back to me. How about you post in the comment section below a link to your aliases or the top 2-3 aliases that you use whenever you use Git. And until next time, have a great time.